ever-increasing urbanization results in a rapid expansion in population growth in cities around the world. This has led to a rise in transport demands. Growing motorization puts a lot of pressure on infrastructure, and more roads for cars don't help at all. We need to get private traffic off the road. Therefore, innovative public transport solutions are urgently required. They not only have to decongest cities and save commuting time, but also offer a sustainable, smart, informative and digital solution that positively impacts the way cities operate. In order to get people off the road, these solutions need to provide an enjoyable experience so that customers not only ride out of necessity, but because they want to. The mobility sector heavily relies on data. To develop innovative and sustainable transport that is enjoyable to all customers, this data will become even more important. Urban transport needs to be digitalized. As of now, there is quite a lot of data available already in the global north. For example, the S-Bahn Munich, the urban rail company in Munich, tracks data for vehicle location, punctuality, capacity in the train carriages, and a variety of different potential disruptions. But of course, we actually have to use the data that is accessible to us in order to develop mobile and big data applications, mobility platforms, APIs, integrated mobility systems, etc. In most of the developing countries, however, the situation is different. Oftentimes, they lack even in the most basic transport data, and in those cases, you have to start with gathering data before you can start using it. But how can the data be processed and used for innovation? By creating a dynamic development process that allows for innovation and makes it possible to get products available on the market fast. For example, the Lean Startup, which consists of three steps. One, the design thinking phase. In that phase, you do research and you try to understand the customer's wants, for example, by identifying their pain points. Two, Lean UX, in which a prototype is built and troubleshooting begins. The third phase is the Agile one. In this phase, one explores the product and tries to get the minimum viable product that is innovative and fulfills all the customer's wants and needs. Mobility data allows us to understand a variety of essential mobility variables. These data points can provide insight into passengers' fluctuations, allows us to understand commuters' behavior, see the impact on different mobility choices by observing social demographic patterns, and get insights into how and why different mobility modes are being used. The information from this data helps to recognize the mobility needs and requirements, identify traffic trends, optimize infrastructure and transport systems, and implement the most convenient, sustainable mobility modes that can also have a positive impact on society and environment. Mobimeo has put some of these things into practice with their white label app. They used the data from connection searches, bookings, the type of ticket that were purchased, departure and destination, journey time, and so on, in order to optimize the operational flow and the customer's experience by analyzing and utilizing all possible data. For example, they can identify trends within their ridership in seconds with collective intelligence systems. This will surely come in handy soon, as the pandemic changed the passengers' transit behavior. It will be interesting to see if there are different trends like weekdays that commuters prefer for home office, leading to less passengers in the public transport system on set days. Or they can see the ratio between searches and bookings. And as we not only want an innovative transport system, but also a sustainable one, you can also see the carbon emissions around the city and determine where it is the highest. Naturally, the footprint will be high where there is a lot of movement, e.g. in city center and around central stations. This information can be used to make these transport hubs as sustainable as possible. As you can see, there's already quite a lot possible with the tools and data we have today. However, as the world continues to digitalize, privacy and data protection laws are gaining in importance and visibility. Hence, we also need to mind the legal framework around the data protection laws and at the same time see to it that the regulations don't hinder innovation. We also need to know and understand the groups of people that use public transport. In urban areas, there are three big groups: the regional commuters, the local commuters, and lastly, the occasional passengers. They each have different demands that must be accommodated. Regional commuters have long journey times, they use regional trains to get into the city, and then urban public transport like the S-Bahn, bus, tram, or non-motorized transport like walking or biking. Urban commuters only use the public transport, including non-motorized transport, in the urban area, and they have shorter journey times. The occasional passenger also uses the urban public transport and sometimes a regional train for a day trip, for example. Commuters, both regional and urban, want an optimized journey time and a consistent timetable. They need planning security and exact information regarding their train line. Regional commuters value continuity and regionality, like live updates and commuting alerts, regional content, etc. Urban commuters, however, value flexibility and personalization more. They want proactive, content-oriented customer service. The occasional passenger might not know the network as well, so they want an uncomplicated journey. They value simplicity, flexibility, and continuity, like intermodal routing from door to door and in-out with best price logic. The three big groups also have different subgroups that need to be accommodated to, and especially the most vulnerable ones, such as women, children, the elderly, people with disabilities, as well as those of lower socioeconomic status, need the data and innovations to make urban transport physically and financially accessible to everyone. The city transit system is a very close-knit, high-frequented network where all modes of transport, S-Bahn, bus, tram, bikes, ride, pooling, car sharing are represented. In both the countryside and the suburbs, however, transport is usually somewhat limited to a few buses a day and the outer branches of the S-Bahn in bigger communities. The most used mode of transport is one's own car. The depiction in the background shows how the distribution of transport in the metropole, countryside and suburbs could look like with new digital mobility solutions. For one, we have the public transport including S-Bahn, U-Bahn, tram, bus and in the future cable cars. They are used to bring people from A to B in the metropole region. In the countryside, the S-Bahn, buses and cable cars can function as a conveyor, bringing people in and out of the metropole. Bikes, especially now with COVID, have gotten a lot more popular recently and we believe their popularity will continue to grow. They are a good alternative within the cities with a lot of car traffic, as you can avoid the traffic jams and the need for parking. They are easy to obtain since there are many bike rental stations throughout the city. Because of this, bikes are also employed for the first and last mile of a journey, bringing the passengers to and from the stations, both in the countryside and in the metropole. Though many cities are not yet laid out to accommodate the increasing bike traffic, bike fast lanes could help bringing bikes less dangerous and get bikers around town even faster. In the countryside and in the suburbs, ride pooling, where two or more parties with the same destination share a vehicle, which has been adapted by cab companies and companies like Uber and Lyft. And car sharing, which is a model of shared mobility where people have access to a network of cars that can be rented for a short amount of time, are especially relevant. As they can have the same flexibility as one's own car, but are also way more sustainable and affordable. These two options are great for the first and last mile and for anybody like elderly people and people with reduced mobility who can't use public transport and bikes quite as easily. Car sharing is also great for day trips or when you have to transport heavy load. Another mobility option that can help decongest cities and serves as a conveyor are roadways. They are smart, reliable, barrier-free and sustainable. They offer a free and obstacle-less ride on a new independent level. The latest innovation is the Oro Autonomous Roadway System from Doppelmayr, which stands for safe mobility with unmanned operations and cutting-edge digital network technology. Oro roadways provide huge benefits in cities where they are seamlessly integrated into the transport network and infrastructure thanks to having a rather short construction time of roughly 2 years. They are also quite affordable as there is no underground construction work necessary. But of course, there are also great projects for the underground and subway. For example, the Essential Connector app by ExxonVibe. It strives to make life easier for the passengers by connecting the city's whole transit system. Not just the underground, but also car sharing companies, buses and everything else in one app, and is basically a personalized travel assistant. For example, it gives out personalized messages like when to get in and out and can arrange transport like shared bikes for the onward journey.